12th of December 1979. A time and a place stamped forever in the memories of Dundee United's football fans. That was the night years of waiting came to an end for the Tannadice club, the night they won their first ever major trophy, and the night that set them off on a fantastic League Cup journey. These scenes of joy were repeated a year later, and tomorrow at Hampden Park, United attempt to become the only club apart from Celtic to win the League Cup 3 years in a row. Yet despite that marvellous run in the competition, despite the fact that they've scored 21 goals in 7 games without defeat, and despite having beaten Rangers 2-0 a couple of weeks ago, Dundee United go into the final against Rangers as underdogs in the eyes of the bookies. A situation that doesn't surprise manager Jim McLean.
Not really. I think that basically the most important factor that the bookies are looking at, that Rangers are playing the game in their second home at Hampden, and obviously the crowd will be far greater numbers for them than there will be for Dundee United. And I think that's the biggest influence in their thinking. But it's not important who's favourite, the only important factor is who wins the cup on Saturday.
Do you think Rangers are a different proposition in a cup final?
Well, most certainly. I think Rangers and Celtic have a tradition. Well, they've been there that often in recent years. But we are quite confident in our own minds that this is the sixth time that we've experienced the pressures and the excitement of a cup final, and we're fairly experienced at what's necessary for Saturday.
You've gone 7 games without losing, but before that you had 7 games where you didn't win. What was the turning point for you?
Well, I think the most important factor obviously was the return of Paul Sturrock from the broken bone in his hand as far as the forwards were concerned, and he most certainly has played a big part in the 21 goals that we have scored. But I think equally important was the form of Paul Hegarty and David Neary, who really have been the backbone of the team in recent years. And I think that they're mainly responsible for 2 goals against in the 7-game period. But we've had an unfortunate season with the players who have been injured. Paul Hegarty with a cartilage operation, Paul Sturrock with a broken bone in his hand, and David Neary has had one injury after another, and I think that getting them all fully fit is the most important factor.
Paul Sturrock has indeed been a revelation in United's recent run of successes with 8 goals in 7 games. He is now being likened to Kenny Dalglish at his best, and many people see him as a natural successor to the Liverpool star in the Scottish team. And watching the knack he has of producing goals out of nothing, few would argue with that. But there was a time when people in Dundee questioned the number 10's fondness for facing the Forsyths or Stevens of football.
Well, at one time I think I've put on a wee bit more weight. I've kind of grown out a wee bit. It helps a wee bit. But definitely when I was a wee bit younger, I had problems playing against more physical players. But I think now that I've learnt to take it to feet, turn quickly, be a wee bit sharp with my play, I think, and also getting a fair crack from the referees, you know what I mean? I think I've been able to overcome that.
You're now being compared with Kenny Dalglish, and a lot of people are suggesting that you could become a successor to Dalglish in the Scotland jersey. Do you liken yourself to him?
I try to mould myself on him, but definitely I would still not say I'm near as good as that boy. He's absolutely brilliant. Was with him in the Scotland squad, and even in training he looks magnificent, you know, finishing, brilliant finisher.
How do you think being chosen for Scotland has helped your game?
It's given me a lot more confidence, that's about the only thing, and attitude as well. It's helped me with my attitude, which sometimes has been lacking in games, you know, but definitely confidence-wise, I think confidence has got a lot to do with football. I'm a lot more confident than I was.
And does that run into Saturday's game?
Well, we'll just have to wait and see.
At one time, doubts would have been expressed about your ability to cope with the physical side of the game. Do you think the players have now learned to handle this side of it?
I think they're learning, but we're still a bit to go. We've definitely got to keep working very, very hard at the determination side of our game, because make no mistake, I don't think there's any doubts about the ability at Dundee United. But we still, as I said, I've definitely got to improve on our determination and our aggression for 90 minutes, because at the end of the day, if we match teams in that side there, it will then be a question of the ability, and that gives us a far better chance of winning the match, but we won't win it on our